In Iceland, the possibility still remains that a volcanic eruption could occur within the evacuated town of Grindavik with little or no warning. If you were to look at the harmonic tremor charts in close proximity to the existing subsurface body of magma, you'd see the first increase in tremor since November 12th. Since volcanic earthquakes are now occurring at incredibly shallow depths of 1 to 3 kilometers, and these quakes just dropped to their lowest level since 2 days after the volcanic unrest began, all the way back on October 25th, you might think that a volcanic eruption is once again imminent. However, you are probably mistaken in this regard, and here is why. While tremor charts do monitor the average intensity of magma movement and earthquakes over a period of time, they also pick up other unwanted signals. These can include a 29.5-day-long cycle of increasing and decreasing activity caused by the pull of the moon, which has a synodic period of that exact length, while also any heavy machinery operating in the area, or in the current case, wind. As on November 21st, southwest Iceland was hit with the first of the season's gales, causing sustained wind speeds to increase from 6 to 33 miles per hour. And this is why it might incorrectly appear that the volcanic tremor has increased. In Grindavik, there is a decent possibility that this town will need to remain closed for months due to solidifying magma which exists at as little as 500 meters below the surface. This magma was placed there on November 10th and 11th, and the spreading of the crust caused more than a dozen large cracks to form, three of which cut through the town. Since these cracks now act as a path of least resistance, degassing magma is releasing toxic sulfur dioxide gas from these regions. Sulfur dioxide forms when at high temperatures in molten rock, native sulfur melts and combines with oxygen. Sulfur dioxide can be lethal with as little as 100 parts per million or 0.01%. While I have not been able to confirm sufficient levels of this gas to be immediately lethal within Grindavik or the surrounding areas, the possibility of this hazard is still a factor to consider for this heavier-than-air gas. As a result, the Iceland Met Office published a new hazard zone map for Grindavik and its surroundings, which I have linked in this video's description, with various colors having the following meanings. Orange indicates a moderate hazard area which you should keep out of as it could contain volcanic hazards. Red indicates a higher risk area where there is a potential for an eruption to begin with absolutely zero warning beforehand. This area also has the potential for dangerous gas emissions and sudden large emissions of toxic gases. The highest risk area is shaded in purple, which has the absolute highest chance of an eruption beginning with zero warning beforehand, is emitting the highest levels of toxic gases, and if for some reason a person was to be authorized to venture into this area, a worn gas mask and carried gas meter would be absolutely required. The good news is that at least for the next few days, the odds of a volcanic eruption seem to have decreased well below 50% and are continuing to decrease with each passing day. But we are not yet in the clear. All the way back on October 23rd, magma began to pool at a location northwest of a mountain called Purbjorn. This spot continued to be the main center of uplift and intruding magma until suddenly on November 9th, magma reached such a volume and pressure that it fractured rock to the east and then to the northeast and southwest, sending magma rushing below a 15.6-kilometer long stretch of the peninsula. The new dike remained the center of ground deformation between November 9th and 12th until on November 13th, the uplift center seemingly returned to its pre-November 9th position. Although this bit is uncertain, magma now appears to once again be recharging the sill at 5 kilometers depth to the northwest of Thorbjorn. This sill could simply wane in activity and then cease like the last four magmatic intrusions in the same area without erupting, or it could cause an exact repeat of what happened on November 9th through 12th. Such a repeat, in my opinion, is the more likely outcome, as magma is likely to eventually reach such a pressure and volume that it once again fractures adjacent rock, sending magma into the very same dike. If this were to occur, there would be very little to stop an eruption from occurring. Thus, while an eruption is not likely to occur today, it becomes almost certain upon the moment magma suddenly moves towards the east and intrudes into the November 10th and 11th dike again. If you enjoyed this video, please comment down below and subscribe to this channel. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's supporters on Patreon and on YouTube via YouTube members.